As I'm sure you're aware, this month is Devtoberfest month, and we got four packed weeks of content for you. We've just finished week one, and here's what we saw. And don't forget, you can watch the replays of any of these sessions whenever you want. On Monday, that's ABAP Day, we looked at the RESTful Application Programming Model set of topics, including developer extensibility and business events, as well as transactional consistency and also dealing with legacy code. On Tuesday, that's User Interface Day, we covered super relevant and modern subjects like state management and data fetching with open source tools and frameworks. On Wednesday, that's the Data and Analytics Day, we focused on machine learning in the context of SAP HANA and SAP Data Warehouse Cloud. On Thursday, Low-Code and No-Code Day, we had five sessions looking at this topic. Look, from a general introductory and conversational session all the way through a deep dive into what SAP Business Application Studio has to offer for this really important area. And on Friday, that's the Cloud Native Development Day. We had a great conversational introduction and also a session on the basics of Kubernetes. Of course, we had some fun with Pettoberfest on Friday. We're doing a little fun event every Friday. And in the Pettoberfest, we got folks to share pictures of their pets at work. What about week two? Well, there's so much to tell you about. I can't fit it into this new segment, so I'm going to get you to read the blog post that has all the details and all the links for you. Looking forward to week two. Happy Devtoberfest.
In the previous news episode, we shared the news that SAP Data Warehouse Cloud had become available for consumption under CPEA in addition to the already existing subscription option. Now product manager Klaus-Peter Sauer published a blog post sharing more news about updates in SAP Data Warehouse Cloud during the Q3 of this year, such as setting compound keys that can now be set in the data builder editors, the use of the OData APIs to search and replicate data following the OData version 4, and the new view analyzer to see the entities that compose your data model. For the complete list of news, please check KP's blog post and join SAP experts for a product update session on October 19th. Are you new to SAP Data Warehouse Cloud or want to understand it better? We got you covered. Join our Devtoberfest sessions from the introduction to SAP Data Warehouse Cloud to deep dives into three exciting capabilities: machine learning with DWC, DBW Bridge, and bidirectional integration between SAP Analytics Cloud and Data Warehouse Cloud for planning. Check the links in the description below.
Did you know that SAP enables everyone in your company to build software and innovate with speed? Whether you are a professional developer or a line of business expert, SAP TechEd is a unique opportunity for everyone to dive into the latest technology trends and innovations. I invite you to join the application development and automation track. Join SAP experts, partners, and customers to hear about the key innovations on our low-code, no-code portfolio and learn how to build apps, automate tedious processes, and design engaging business sites with drag-and-drop simplicity. If you are more into coding, I invite you to explore the latest developer productivity enhancements on SAP BTP, for example on ABAP or SAP Business Application Studio. Meet our experts and get hands-on with our latest product innovations, such as new integrations, visual cloud functions, and design themes. Save your spot today and register for SAP TechEd 2022. See you in November.
It's October now, and the developer advocates have all treats and no tricks for you this month. In particular, we have some great in-person developer events planned for those of you here in the United States. First of all, we have the ASUG SAP BTP Summit coming up in the Newtown Square offices, October 18th and 19th. Then we're going to have a bunch of hands-on exercises as a part of this event, including ones that cover ABAP and SAP UI5 and many other topics. Later that same week in the Atlanta ASUG chapter meeting, we'll also be there delivering an ABAP hands-on code jam. That will be on Friday, October 21st. Then the following week in Dallas, Texas, again, we'll be with the ASUG chapter meeting, this one being the Texas statewide and Oklahoma chapter meeting. And we'll be bringing the SAP Cloud Application Programming Model with SAP HANA Cloud Code Jam to that event. So we've got a lot of great hands-on opportunities coming your way in just a couple of weeks this month. If you're in any of those areas, we hope to see you at one of those in-person events.
I'm a big fan of the Open Documentation Initiative, where we expose the source of SAP Help Portal content on GitHub so that we can collaborate with you on it to improve it. The number of documentation sets in the initiative has been growing steadily, and I just wanted to highlight some of the recent additions. So first, there's the SAP Custom Domain Service Guides, the main onboarding documents for creating and managing custom domains on SAP BTP Cloud Foundry environment. Then there are a couple of guides related to developer community relevant content for SAP HANA Cloud. And rounding off this list, the SAP BTP Neo environment documentation is also now part of this initiative. We want to make it as easy as possible for you to collaborate with us, whether that's to provide feedback or even contribute content, and that's what the Open Documentation Initiative is all about. So read more about it in the blog posts linked in the description.
Oliver Graf announced this week that the updated version of the SAP UI5 roadmap is now available in the SAP Roadmap Explorer. It's worth the log on to learn about all the planned developments in the various areas, such as Fiori, UI5 interface controls, developer tooling, user interface flexibility, and the open source development aspects. Link, as always, in the video description.